Open up your mouth for Jesus on this morning. Thank you, Lord, for all you have done for me. Thank you, Lord, for sanctifying me, God.
Let's give him a hallelujah praise in this place. Come on, let's celebrate the King.
because of who you are. I give you praise.
Thank you.
And I give you glory. because of who he is. There's no condemnation. No condemnation. I don't care what I was labeled as or what I'm labeled is. There's no condemnation in Christ. He sees us all as his brothers and sisters because we're heirs, joint heirs with him. Oh, I've been adopted by the Father where I can cry out, I'm a father unto him. Oh, I've been spiritually adopted in the family of God, in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's give God some praise one more time. Amen.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to
magnify the name of Jesus on this morning. Hallelujah. Somebody magnify the name of Jesus. I'm excited about the name. I reverence the name of Jesus. Yeah. For the apostle of miracles on this morning.
But God, with His unconditional love, but God. need. Oh God, just give them a hand praise. Just give them a hand praise. Amen. Hallelujah. If your hand hurts, just praise your hands. Amen. Acknowledge the presence. Amen. Acknowledge the sacrifice. Hallelujah. I thank God for Jesus. Amen. Praise God for He's such an awesome God. I thank God for what He did for me. Amen. I praise God. Amen. Praise God that He never turned His back. Amen. Praise God He was always there. He promises to always, amen, be there. He said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. Amen. Until the end of the age. Oh, I'm so grateful to God today. I'm so grateful. Amen. I exalt Him today. He's so excellent in all His ways. Hallelujah. I just magnify His holy name. Amen. Praise God. I thank God for Jesus. Amen. Because it's so awesome. He is so awesome. Amen. How many of you know what I'm talking about? I thank God for Jesus. Amen. Turn in the Word of God. Amen. To the Word of God in Matthew 20. My intent is not to be before you long. Amen. Praise God that you may go, amen, and partake with family and friends. Praise God and continue just to praise God, amen, for the great sacrifice by which He has done for the eternal work of our lives, amen. There's a message that's being preached throughout the land, amen. Praise God. It's the one time, amen, praise God, when the preachers and the teachers, amen, the apostles, prophets, and pastors, amen, those that deliver the word, amen, praise God. When we come together, amen, praise God, in uniformity, amen, to declare the power of God, amen. This is Resurrection Sunday, amen. This is Resurrection Sunday, amen. Praise God. I thank God for Jesus because He has risen, amen. The word of God declares, I'm going to read a little bit. I'm going to allow you to take your seats, amen. The word of God declared in Matthew chapter 20, amen. Starting at the first verse, for the word of the Lord says, for the kingdom of heaven is likened to a man that is a householder, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers into the vineyard. We thank God for Jesus. You may have your seats, amen. We thank God and we honor Him for His word, amen. We thank God, amen, for each and every one of you, amen, that are assembled in the house of God under the body of Christ, amen. The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that you remember Jesus, amen, praise God, because we've never been to heaven and because we can't really understand heavenly things, amen. Because our mind, as the word of God declares, we were born in sin and we were shaped in iniquity. And although we've been saved, amen, praise God, our mindset cannot capture, amen, divinely giving things, amen. Praise God. So when Jesus was speaking to His disciples, amen, praise God, He had to break some things down in a way that could be received, amen. Praise God. I thank God for Jesus, amen, that He took the time to give a parable to speak of a heavenly truth, amen. For the word of God declares, amen, that the kingdom of heaven is unto a man as a householder, amen, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers in the vineyard, amen. I thank God for Jesus, amen, praise God. But when I look at this first dimension of seeking, amen, praise God, as the householder, amen, praise God, went out because there was a work in the vineyard to be done. How many of you know it's work to be done, amen, praise God. The battle wasn't given to the swift, amen, or the battle too strong, but them that endure to the end, amen. So I thank God for Jesus, amen, that there's a work for us that are enduring, amen. Anybody enduring in the house, amen. Praise God. I thank God for Jesus. Any endurers in the house, amen. Praise God. You didn't endure a hard time, but I survived because the Lord Almighty was on my side, amen. I've been, amen, praise God, through the mountaintops and down below in the valleys, amen. But I made it because of the Lord thy God was on my side, amen. Praise God. They tried to count me out. Death tried to take my life. The enemy tried to steal, kill, and destroy me. But I thank God for Jesus because of the purpose that lives upon the inside. I got another chance. Amen. So I thank God for Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Thanking God. Amen. Praise God that it wasn't given to the swift and the strong, but the those that will endure. Amen. The word of God declares that in this first level of seeking, amen, praise God, He went out looking, amen, praise God, for those, amen, praise God, who was of able disposition, amen, to get the work done. Amen. The word of God said that He went out early
amen, praise God, to seek laborers, amen, praise God, to do the work, amen. God bless you, Sister Raquel. The word of God declares, amen, praise God, Brother Ed, God bless you. The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that in that first level of seeking, amen, praise God, he went out to find folks early in the morning, amen, praise God, that was ready, equipped, and waiting, amen, praise God, to do the work. I thank God for Jesus, amen, that there was another level of seeking, because how many of you, amen, know you wasn't ready in that first time, amen. Praise God, I thank God for Jesus. That's one thing about salvation. I realize that I'm not deserving of it, amen. I realize that I'm not worthy, amen. I realize that my best work is as filthy rags, amen. I thank God for Jesus because in that first lineup, amen, praise God, he began to identify people, amen, that were capable for the work, amen. He began to identify those, amen, praise God, that had the ability, amen, to work in the vineyard. The word of God declares that he went out about the third hour and he saw others standing idle in the marketplace. We got some folks, amen, praise God, when God sent his first and second level of seeking out, amen, when he went out looking, amen, he may have found you standing idle, amen. How many of you know, amen, praise God, that many times, amen, when the Spirit of the Lord is drawing you, amen, praise God, I'm just standing around, amen, I'm just kind of just chilling, as they say, amen. You call somebody and say, what you doing? Nothing, just chilling, amen, praise God. And I thank God for Jesus, for the word of God declared, amen, that there was a seeking, amen, praise God, for those that were just chilling, amen, those that were standing around, hallelujah, those that were needed something to do. But I thank God for Jesus, amen, that he didn't stop there, for the word of God declares, again, he went out about the sixth and the ninth hour, and he did likewise, and about the 11th hour, somebody said 11th hour.
11th hour.
The 11th hour, he went out and he found others standing idle, and he said unto them, he said, why you stand here all day idle, amen, and they said unto him, because no man has hired us. See, now I want you to know, amen, praise God, that some of us may be 11th hour Christians, amen, but we made it, hallelujah. I may not got it right the first time, but I made it, hallelujah. I may not have done all things right when God first called me. I may not have answered the call to salvation, but glory unto the Lord God Almighty that he went out seeking. The word of God says he seek them that he may save them, amen. The word of God declares, amen, that his heart panteth, amen, hallelujah, to declare his goodness in the lives of his people, amen. Don't you know that he stands waiting for you to cry out unto him? He's standing waiting for your heart to repent. The word of God declares in Revelations, amen, praise God, when the seventh seal of judgment was broke, when God could have called it a day and he could have declared judgment on this whole world, the word of God says that he still yet waited another hour and a half waiting for his people, waiting for the touch of God to touch his people, waiting for the cry of repentance. I want you to know that God is waiting. He's waiting on us. Hallelujah, Jesus. He's waiting on us not to get perfect, but to become willing. The word of God says that he sent out the laborer to look, amen, for laborers in the vineyard. The word of God says that the husbandman said, why are you just standing idle? Why are you standing here? You've been doing nothing all day. Many of us, amen, taking our whole life, amen, to follow our own mindset. The word of God declares, amen, praise God, lean not to your own understanding. But some of us, amen, we lean to our own understanding time and time again. But I thank God for Jesus, because in that 11th hour, I may not have been ready the first go around. I may have been
You know the story.
Yes.
You know the documentation. The word of God declares, amen, that here it is, Sammy was lying down sleeping, a young lad. But the voice of the Lord began to call. Don't you know when God is calling you, it calls you out of your comfort. When the Spirit of the Lord begins to call, it draws you out. You don't feel comfortable where you are no more. The baby got up and he went to his spiritual father and he said, did you call me? Because that's all he knew was the voice of his leader. And the word of God declares that Samuel said, no, son, I didn't call you. Go ahead and lay down. And the word of God says, amen, that God began to call him again. How many of you glad that he didn't give up on you the first time? Yes. He called your name again. Yes. Word of God declares that Samuel got up and he went to Eli's bedside. He said, you did call me. He said, no, son, I didn't call you. Go lay down. Put the covers over you. Take a nap, amen. And the word of God says that a third time, somebody say a third time, and that 11th hour, amen. Praise God, he broke through his understanding. He broke through his carnality. He broke through Eli's head, and he began to declare, amen, when Samuel came running back in there, and he said, Daddy, you did call me, amen. He began to hear the voice of the Lord, and he said, oh, yeah,
yeah.
He saw beyond my name. He saw beyond my talk, God. And he saw the Jesus. I thank God that Jesus said he looked beyond my fault. And he kept knocking. How many of you hear the knocking voice of God? He's knocking at your door. He's knocking at your door. He said, I'm not going to leave. I'm going to keep knocking. Huh? I'm not going to leave. But I'm so hurt, God. But I'm not. I don't care. I'm going to keep knocking. So you open up and let me in. But God, I've been going through, God. Brother God, I don't even know if you can fix me. But I'm going to keep knocking, son. Now, I'm going to keep knocking, daughter. Huh? I'm going to keep knocking because when I knock, amen, I know that you'll answer because you're mine. I know that you're going through something. I know your mind's not on me right now. Oh, I know you think you're young and invincible. I know you think you're all right. But there's a time that's coming that you want to know that you need me against all odds. There's a time that's coming. Thank God. And he stands at the door. And he knocks. He knocks. That's why sometimes he talks and we turn and knock. Because he's knocking. He's knocking. I hear him calling me. I hear him calling me. I hear him calling me. He's knocking. The word of God declares, amen. He said that in that 11th hour, amen. Again, he went about, amen. Praise God. And he said he went out and found others standing idle. And he said unto them, why stand ye here all day idle? And they said unto him, because no man has hired us. He said unto them, go ye also into the vineyard. And whatsoever is right, that shall ye receive. The word of God says that they were standing around. I'm just a misfit. Nobody wants me. I'm just a misfit. I think nobody won't hire me. Everybody's looking over me. Because they see the blemishes of my life. They see my criminal record. They see, amen, praise God, my dope. They see me, amen, in my sin. They see me in my drug addiction. They see me, amen, just as I am. God, they see look beyond your fault. I'm not looking at your stain, son. I'm not looking at your blemishes, daughter. But I'm calling you closer. I'm calling you closer. I'm calling you closer. Boy, my heart is doing this out. God is not looking at your failures. He sees you in the way that he sees you. He sees you a finished product. He sees you, amen, with all your hurt healed. He sees you, amen, as a victorious one. He sees you as his son and as his daughter. To see the shame, I can't come to the holy God because, see, I'm still smoking cigarettes. I'm still on the pipe, amen. I'm still doing my thing, amen. And God says, come unto me, all of them that labor, and I will give you rest. Somebody say, I'm tired. I'm tired. I need the rest of the Lord. I need the rest of the Lord. I need his peace. I need his strength. I need his glory. I need his power. I need his presence. You can be right here in the church and say, God, I need you. I need you to break.
pass the information for me. And today, amen, we're going to come together. Just as in that day, with the presence of the Lord being in our midst, our Lord Jesus Christ, and we will take that meal. There was a Friday night, amen, that he sat with his disciples. He said, on this night, I must give my life. The eternal sacrifice that they didn't understand. And sometimes, amen, we don't even understand. But we partake of it. Graciously. But I thank God for Jesus as they're uncovering the sacraments, amen, that we got an opportunity to partake of his glory, of his victory. We never want to forget what Jesus did for us. He gave his life, amen. The word of God says, amen, praise God, in that Garden of Gethsemane, the night that he had to give his life, amen, the night that he was betrayed by his loved one, the word of God declares, amen, praise God, that he cried out unto his Father, if this cup can pass. He knew the agony that came with the cup. I remember, amen, as a young preacher, a young pastor, amen, about 2002. When the mantle was first passed to me, amen, I remember we didn't have no oil. And the Spirit of the Lord said, go get a cup of water. So I sent one of my armor bearers to get a cup of water, and they got the cup of water, and I prayed for pretty much everybody in the house with that water. I began to anoint them and lay hands and anoint them. And when I looked at that water, when I was done, it was all kind of particles. All kind of hair and things that you wouldn't put in your body. And I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, can you drink of this cup? I like to regurgitate it when he said, can you drink of this cup? The woman brought her two sons and she said, look, she said, I'm bringing you my sons because I want my sons to sit at the right and left hand. You know us mothers, amen, we want to promote our children. We want to get them where we think they need to be. But he had to let him know, amen, praise God, that it's not given to me, amen, to give up these seats. And they not able to drink of this cup. As I stood there, 35 years old, in the first year of my pastorate, I'm looking in this cup, this bitter, nasty cup. And I say, God, you took the cup for me. And I'm going to take the cup for you. And I took it. And I drank it. Yeah, I did that too. Amen. Praise God. I took up the cup. There's some cups in our life, amen, praise God, that we run from. But God has called us closer. God, as you draw me closer, I understand, amen, that it's going to be challenging. I understand as you draw me closer, Lord God, it's going to cost me something. As you draw me closer, Lord, I understand, amen, there's going to be some separation that I must render. But I'm willing to drink of that cup. I'm willing. I'm willing. Why am I willing? Because I know that the great glory is right on the other side. I adore Paul, and I love the way he said, amen, he said, these light afflictions that I go through in this doesn't compare to the glory of God that I shall receive. Amen. I'm willing to press towards the mark. Yeah. See, sometimes we get used to the easy street. But he says, I'm willing to press towards the mark of the prize of the high call in Christ Jesus. There is no higher call than you. So I'm ready to press. I'm ready to push. I'm ready to stand. I'm ready to declare his will. I'm ready to do the work that he's called me to do. I'm ready to sit at his feet. I'm ready to hear his voice. I'm ready to answer the call of God. He's calling me closer to him. He's calling me in His power. He's calling me in His glory. He's calling us into His presence. Have you experienced the presence of the Lord? Some of us say, I haven't experienced the presence of the Lord in a long time. Oh, but when you bask in His presence, when He enters the room, amen, it just makes everything all right. You could be in a jail cell looking at 90 to life, but when He stepped into your situation, there's a hope, amen, praise God, that everything's going to be all right. Because He took the cross for us. He took the cross for us. That Friday night He sat with His disciples. And He broke bread. The Word of God says, and as they were eating, Jesus took bread and He blessed it. And He broke it. And He gave it to His disciples and He told them to take it, eat this. This is My body. He took the cup and He gave thanks and He gave it to them saying, drink ye all of it. For this is My blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sin. The Word of God declared in the Old Testament, amen, praise God, that only the shedding of pure blood can be the sacrifice of the remission of sin. They had to find certain animals and they had to find certain cattle and certain things to slay upon the altar. But Jesus said, I'll go. I'll be the final for them all. Thank you, Jesus. Today, amen, as Minister Ray Trail blessed the sacrifice, the sacraments, amen, praise God. And as Minister Linda, amen, praise God, lead us into the prayer, amen, of forgiveness of sin. We want to take a look at ourselves. We want to take inventory in our lives, amen, to see where and why haven't I drawn closer to Him. I want to take a moment, amen. This ain't for the babies, amen. Don't serve the babies. Don't serve the babies. This is for the saved. If you've accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, amen, praise God, this ordinance is for you. You may say, I'm not worthy. None of us are worthy. This is why we pray, God, forgive me of my sins. I'm acknowledging and being accountable.
Yes.
For my error, for my transgressions, for my iniquities. God, you will forgive me. I want to feel your draw.
Yes.
But this time, I want to come closer. I'm going to answer the call. Minister Rachel, then Minister.
Search their hearts, God. search their minds on today, God. In the name of Jesus, God, that there will be, God, no stumbling block, God, to restore, God, unto them, oh God, the rightful relationship that you have set before us, oh God, because you said that if we believe, God, but by faith, God, in the name of Jesus, God, we have to believe in our hearts, God. We repent, God, from every sin, God, knowingly, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. And we give you glory, God, and we thank you, God, for restoration, God. We thank you, God, for creating in us, oh God, a clean heart, God, and renewing, oh God, with thought of those, oh God, a right spirit on today, God, in the name of Jesus, God. I thank you, God. Examine yourself. Take a moment just to examine yourself.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, God wants to restore today. He wants to restore fellowship. And he wants us to know how much he loves us. In the name of Jesus. And I thank you, God, for the forgiveness of sin, God. I thank you, God, for the believers, oh God, the faith, oh God, that have stepped out spiritually, privately, God, to restore the rightful connection, God, in the name of Jesus, to the vine, which is you, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. I praise you, and I'm thankful today in Jesus'
name. Amen. 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 God, for Jesus, amen. If you will distribute the sacraments, amen. Praise God. We're thanking God for Jesus, amen, for the shedding of his blood. We're thanking God for Jesus, amen. Because as we all sit amongst this table, we all have done something that separates us from God. Oh, my God, I'm so faithful. They talked about Peter, amen, because he denied Christ. Many of us, amen, praise God, denied Christ over and over and over. You may not have denied him in your verbal accountability, amen, but you denied him in your responses.
Yeah.
Some of us, amen, praise God. We talk about Judas, amen, how he betrayed the Lord, amen. But many of us, amen, have betrayed God in our own ways, amen, praise God. We crucified him
afresh.
Many of us, amen, we talk about Pilate, amen, the Pontius Pilate. He could have did something to keep our Lord from the cross. Word of God said he placed his hand in the basin and he washed his hands and he said, I have nothing to do with this man. Many times, amen, praise God, we've looked at the will of God for our lives, amen, and we washed our hands and we said, Lord, we want nothing to do with this. When he was calling us, amen, praise God, to stand and declare, to say and to do, I washed my hands and act like I didn't even speak. Like the disciples, when God woke us up to pray and said, I need you to pray, I need you to pray, we just rolled over and went back to sleep. We all stand guilty before him. We all stand guilty before you. I thank God for Jesus, amen. When they had taken him away, amen. Many of the disciples, amen, praise God, they turned and they left. They didn't even wait to see to our Savior and our Lord. Many of us, amen, we turned our backs on God. Oh, I know it's a hard pill to swallow, amen. But truth is good for us, so.
Amen.
So that I may repent.
Yes.
And ask the Lord, forgive me. Forgive me, Lord God. Jesus, forgive me of how I denied you. God, forgive me how I betrayed you. God, forgive me for taking things loosely.
Yes.
Forgive me for not standing and declaring the word of God. Forgive me. How many of you know, amen, God, I need your forgiveness. I thank you for your blood, God. I thank you for your blood. I thank you for shedding the blood on Calvary's Christ. On Calvary's cross, amen. I thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Just every Thank you, Lord God. Everyone's been served. Amen. Praise God, people serve. Sister Alexander. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Also, Sister Melisha in the rear. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, Mr. DeAndre, help us sing this song. Amen. This is why when we take up the sacraments, we don't get Ritz crackers, sweet loaves, and club crackers, because the sacrifice of our Lord's body was not sweet nor tasty or common. We want to remember what he did for us. As we hold the fruit of the vine in our hands, that's in representation of the blood that was shed for us. The New Testament, which means the new order. It doesn't mean just Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. What it means, amen, is he changed the order of things. You see, in the beginning, amen, praise God, when God created the heavens and the earth, he created Adam and Eve, and he created everything, amen. And the world was good. It was perfect. But the word of God says, amen, praise God, that Satan had his way. And the body of a snake, it wasn't a snake that was Satan. But the spirit of Satan had his way.
and he deceived the woman, which caused the man to sin. And since then, they gave way for the power of darkness, for the power of the enemy. This is why we have the impulses that we have. This is why we have the cloak of sin that we have. This is why we have the desires of sin that we have, the appetites that we have, because the enemy has come to have his way. But I thank God for a second. He still gave us choice, but he gave us power over our circumstance. He gave us power, therefore we don't have to be bound by the impulses and the sin declaration that had been spoken over our lives. We're no longer bound, amen, to the road of death and destruction because of what he's done. So today we come together to receive the blood, the sacrifice that was shed for you and me, that we may be free in Jesus' name. Take and drink. On that Friday night, they went away. The word of God declares, amen, that they came and they got our Lord. They came to get Jesus. Oh, they took him from court to court. They did some illegal stuff and they hired some false witnesses, amen, praise God, to make him look guilty of a crime he never committed. See, for me, they didn't have to hire no false witnesses, amen, because I was guilty. But our Lord, amen, praise God, never sinned, amen. The word of God says, amen, they came after him with swords. He said, you don't need no sword because I'm willing to go willingly. Because I'm going to be that sacrifice. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that after he was taken from court to court, amen, after they said all manner of evil against him, after they beat him all night long, amen, like cat of nine tails, amen, which is a whip that has these metal prongs coming out of it, that when he whipped his back, amen, it would dig into his skin and tear his flesh off his back. As he suffered, amen, praise God, being ridiculed by the crowd. As they set a crown of thorns upon his head. I need you to know, amen, praise God, this wasn't no ordinary whipping.
All right.
The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that they made him carry his own cross. The word of God says that as he was bloody and bruised, amen, they had him carry a cross, amen, and they walked him down the city street so that everyone could look. They say, look, this is you, what you call your Savior, your Messiah. Just a week before, they were laying out palm leaves saying, Hosanna, Hosanna. And now they're standing before the courts saying, crucify him. But the word of God says he went and never said a mumbling word. They hung our Lord to the cross for your sins and for mine. The word of God said, amen, praise God, that they had beaten him so much that he was unidentifiable. They didn't know if he was a human or a beast hanging on that cross. So the pictures that we see that we can barely take doesn't even come shy of telling the story.
Yes.
The word of God says that while he hung on that cross, what's some of the things he said? Y'all just came from Good Friday service. What's one of the things that he said up there? Forgive them, Lord. Well, I'm ready to come off this cross if it was me. I'm ready to kick not only some devil butt, but your butt too. But he says, forgive them, Lord, for they know not what they do. What else he said? Ooh, where Bible scholars at? What else did he say? Seven last sayings of Christ. Come on, y'all. Come on, Stevie.
Why did that?
Here it is, why he is bearing the sins of you and me. He bared my fornications. He bared my drug addictions. He bared my lying, my gossiping, my backbite. Why he got all my sins on him. Amen. Praise God. God himself had to look away from the life that he did not bear. And he felt, for the first time, he felt the separation between him and his father. You remember, he said, me and my father are one. When you see me, you see my father. But for the first time, he felt forsaken, empty, and void. Like many of us feel at times. But I need you to know that the father was not gone. What else did he say? He even took the time to put some business in order. The word of God declares, amen, that he took the time, amen, praise God, to take care of his earthly business.
Yes.
He told the disciple that he loved, he said, take care of my mom. Mothers, can you imagine standing at the foot of the cross, watching your son be brutally beaten, sitting on a cross, hanging from a cross, dying. My mama told me something one day that was so profound that it was just deep to me. My mother said, amen, praise God. She said, I can't compare myself to Mary. She said, but I know the hurt that I feel when I see the people crucify my daughter. And I don't go through the crucifixion that Jesus went through. But mothers, amen, and fathers, amen, when you see your son and your daughter going through, it hurts. It hurts. The word of God, amen, praise God, as Minister DeAndre was declaring, amen, praise God, the word of God states, amen, praise God, that he found pleasure.
Yes.
And seeing his son afflicted.
Yes.
I know that's hard to grasp. But the thing of it was, I got it when my daughter was going through job court. My daughter was holding on. She was going through this drama. She was going through that drama. She was going through the ups and downs of just trying to get through school. And many times, amen, it got hot and heavy and she could have gave up. But I found pleasure in seeing her breasts.
Amen.
I found pleasure, though it hurt, though it's uncomfortable, I see you pressing. I see you getting to the victory because you know the victory is on the other side.
Amen. Amen.
God many times looks at our lives, amen, and he see your endurance. He see you hanging in there. He see you not giving in to the lust of the flesh. He see you not giving in to the quick fix, that instant gratification. He sees you not giving in to what's comfortable, but you're pressing towards the mark. I know it's hard. That's why I'm here, to give you strength. That's why he's there. He said, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you. I'm going to give you strength. Hold on. What else did he say?
I thirst.
He said, I thirst, because he had given out everything that he had within him. They thought he was thirsty, that he just wanted a drink of water. They thought that he needed something, amen, to hydrate him, but he was empty because he was emptying out. Don't you know that we all got to empty out? I got to empty out my carnality so he can fill me up. So he can fill me up. He thirsts, amen, praise God, because he was giving up himself to be the ultimate sacrifice. What else did he say?
Eloi, Eloi, lama sabat.
Go ahead, though. That's my mama. Amen. She speaks two different languages. Amen. But we already did that with another thing anyway. Amen. Yeah, why have I forsaken me? Right. Amen. Amen. Anything?
Giving up the ghost.
Amen. Into thy hands I commend my spirit. After it was all said and done, after he had went through 42 generations of birth to be born of a woman, clothed in a robe of flesh, after he walked this earth healing and delivering and raising the dead, showing the power that's within us, after he went forth and he built God's church through his own blood and body, and ultimately taking the cross, he says, now I commit my spirit to you. They didn't kill me. My spirit was in place to the moment that it is finished. My spirit must not leave this body until every prophecy has been fulfilled. Every word of God has been established. My spirit cannot leave this body until the full order of redemption has been made. Aren't you glad about it? He will not release his spirit. regardless of the pain, you ever see somebody in the hospital and they just want to die already?
Yes.
Just let me go. But he says, I'm going to hold on. I will not allow my spirit to leave this body for the relief of this pain until it's all been established. Why? So that we may have redemption today.
Amen.
The word of God declares, amen, praise God, that he went, amen, praise God, and he gave of his spirit. He gave of himself. And the word of God says, amen, praise God, that they took him off the cross, amen, and they put him in an old borrowed tomb, amen. The word of God declared, amen, praise God, that on that Friday night, amen, praise God, they put him in that tomb. Come on, help me out, Eric, amen. They put him in that tomb, amen, praise God, and I thank God for Jesus, because the word of God declared, amen, that the centurion soldiers, amen, they said, we're going to roll this stone in front of the cave, because see, I heard a rumor that said that he was supposed to get up on the third day. He said, I don't want the people to come steal his body and tell a lie and say he arose, but I want you to know, hallelujah, that the stone could not change the story. I want you to know, amen, that they rolled that big old stone in front of that tomb. And the word of God declares that early, somebody say early, early one Sunday morning. Oh, I can imagine on Saturday night, there was a rumbling that was going on in that tomb. Something was happening, amen. If you were standing on the outside, you would probably say, what was that? Hallelujah, because I need you to know that heaven was receiving his son. I thank you for Jesus, because early Sunday morning, the word of God declared that the women went to the tomb. When they got to the tomb, they found that the big old stone had been removed. My Bible tells me that the woman, she looked in and she saw that Jesus was no longer there. She saw that Jesus was no longer in the tomb. And the word of God declared that she began to sit down and she began to cry. She began to weep. She said, why have they stolen my Lord? Why have they taken the body of my faith? But I want to know that something happened in her spirit. And she looked up and she saw two angels. They say, why are you sitting here amongst the dead? He said, he has the rose, amen. They didn't take his body. He has the rose, amen. He has risen. He
Yes.
I may have washed my hands. I may have turned my back. But I've been restored. I've been set free. There's a reconciliation from me and God. Because he has arisen. He's arisen. And because he's arisen, I have power. I know who I am. I'm no longer a child of the deceiver. See, with Simba on Lion King, he didn't know who he was. So that demonic uncle Scar was able to cause him to move away from his inheritance. Oh, but when you know who you are, you may have forgotten who you are in Christ Jesus. I just want you to stay. I just want you to stay. Somewhere down this road, life circumstances and just trying to simply make it, I forgot who I was in Christ Jesus. I forgot that I'm the head and not the tail. I forgot that I'm above and not beneath. I started operating beneath type behavior.
All right.
I started operating tail-like functions. And God had to remind me, I called you to be the head. Comforted enough. As you're standing, we're going to pray today. We're going to pray. We're going to pray, amen, that the intent of this day, the intent of this day is to give you power to destroy the works of Satan. God says in his word, the intent of the church, and you are the church. The church ain't this building with the address 2916 West Manchester. It's just a place we assemble. We can assemble in the park. We can assemble at Trash House. No?
No.
Well, at Eric's house. Well, we can assemble somewhere else. You know that church just ain't no good music. But the church. Is it you? Is it you? I am the church. I am the church. I am the church. So today, amen, we're going to put God back on the throne of his church. Come in the name of Jesus. We know, God, that we have all sinned, fallen short of your glory. Lord God, we all know, Lord Jesus, that in some infraction or some just downright violation, in some way of sin and iniquity, we transgressed your way for us. Today, oh God, we ask you to forgive us, God. I make no promises right now, God. I make you no promise, but you said if I come, that's as I am. Thank you. get down to this altar.
He rose for you that you might have grace.
wrongs for you, in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare, oh God, that the power of resurrection, resurrect a dead place, resurrect the places, oh my God, of our life, the carnal places of our heart, God.
Thank you.
come in, not as a conqueror of love, not as a servant of love, but as a child. When I go to God, I'm going to say, God, here's your great apostle, apostle of miracles. I don't present myself to you. I say, God, here's your child. Broken and broken. Come on, make up your order. Because when I'm in God, when I'm in God, I can receive of everything. Because remember, I'm a child. But if I don't establish that first establishment, then I can take the $5 less, and that's all I get. Those of you in the pew that don't want to come up, amen, praise God, just repeat that with me. But the intent of your heart and the conviction of your spirit. Those of you that are standing here, amen. God says, amen, if you be ashamed of me before men, I will be ashamed of you before the end. You stand here today because you're not ashamed. Because you know, amen, praise God, who God is in your life.
Yes.
Into that place. Let's put some repentance music on. Amen. Get in that place where it's just you and God. This ain't going to take all day. And just talk to me. I don't want this to be a prayer where you just repeat after me. I can repeat after the governor. I can repeat after Obama. But if my heart ain't in it, they just words. So I need you to get to that place where you're just talking to God. And I'm just going to help you to navigate you to where you need to be. And that's where I'm going to ask you to repeat after me, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
Father, I forgot who I am. In certain situations of my life, I've been distracted from you.
From you.
But Lord, I thank you that you weren't distracted from me. Forgive me.
Forgive me.
I ask you, God, to come into my heart. I receive your Son as my Lord and Savior. I know that Jesus is the Son of God. And he shed his blood.
And he shed his blood.
Just for me. So set me out.
Set me out.
Into your arms, God.
Into your arms, God.
Fill me up.
Fill me up.
With your spirit.
With your spirit.
That I may be made whole. I love you, Lord. The best that I know how.
The best that I know how.
But God, I desire.
God, I desire.
To establish a relationship with you. I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord.
And the pardon of my sins, I receive you. In Jesus'
name.
Amen. For you. I thank God for Jesus. Somebody just give God a hand.
To live on, to go on, to survive, to continue, to persist, to preserve, to remain, to stay.
Mercy, and just most of all, for his faithfulness. In spite of everything that we have done wrong, he still continues to show his faithfulness. Even back in the beginning, when he first created the heavens and the earth, the moons, the stars, the whole solar system, the lands, the oceans, the animals, the creatures, even the last of them,
all this work that he has given unto us, amen. I can't help but to give him glory.
I'm going to be
in the